الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله إليك آياتك للناس بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون أما بعد فقد قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم الله الذي خلقكم من دف ثم جعل من بعد دف قوة صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين وشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين All praises of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one and only being deserving of all worship, the creator of everything that exists. He is the creator and everything else is his creation. He has no beginning and he has no ending. Everything else that he has created had a beginning and will have an end. We seek his help and we seek his forgiveness. And we send our salutations and peace and blessings on his last and final messenger Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. As to what follows, my dear beloved brothers and sisters, you know there are many things in this life that it goes unnoticed to us. Even we our own selves, with the progress of creation, with the different stages of the human personality, sometimes we live our life through these stages not realizing the importance of it. And the stages that we went through, Allah in his infinite mercy, the creator of everything, including us, the human being, gave us in one ayat of Quran our beginning of creation and the stages of that beginning until the end of our life in this world, in one ayat. So I decided to share that with you all this morning, and you know, and including myself, you know, to reflect on our creation. We reflect on so many things in this life, so many things that amuse us, so many things that are, you know, astonishing to us. Whether it is an animal, whether it is a vehicle, whether it is an airplane, whether it is whatever it is, a building, spaceship, battleship. We reflect on these things and admire these things, you know. But have we ever reflect on our own self? I mean, all of us here are grown-ups. And we have reached a stage perhaps we have not realized from the beginning of our creation until where we are now in this world and what will come after. In Surah Ar-Rum, ayah number 54, this is chapter number 30, ayah number 54, a very beautiful ayah, speaking about ourselves, Allah is telling us about ourselves. And as I said, perhaps we live through life and we have not reflected on these stages in our lives. So the young ones, the old ones, It might be interesting to all of us. So Allah SWT begins this ayat by saying, you know, Allahu ladhi khalaqakum min duf. It is He, Allah, who has created you weak or in a state of weakness. So there is one point in our lives, even before we came into this world, and immediately coming into this world, this is the stage Allah SWT is referring to. And you think about it. Allah created us from a nutfa, from a drop. And from that nutfa, it developed into stages. Flesh, bones. And it is in a solitary confinement. It is in the chamber or the womb of the mother. You and I, you know. Allah is speaking of them. For 9 months in solitary confinement. Knows nothing. Helpless. Not even the mother knows what is going on inside of her. And this is the stage Allah is telling us about. He has created us in a state of weakness. Cannot help ourselves. Dependent, solely dependent on something or someone. And that is Allah. Allah is telling us here, in that stage of weaknesses, you need my help. And it is I, Allah, who take you through these stages of development. So let me look at it and reflect back on where we are and how we begin to develop our life. We cannot help but thanking Allah. The Beloved Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one hour of contemplation is better than 1 year of adoration. Let me say that again. 1 hour in contemplation of the creation of Allah is better than 1 year of adoration. It means to say, you may spend your whole life adoring something, but not realizing the one who brought it into being. On the other hand, you have the individual, 1 hour's contemplation is better than 1 year of, you know, adoration. When you think about something that amazes you, that, you know, inspires you, and you look at your own self, this contemplation on your own self, from what you were to what you are now, reflecting on the Creator and who won, the one who has brought you into being, thanking Him for the life that you have. So in that stage of weaknesses, which will include the beginning of the process of creation, and as I said, 9 months, who was sustaining you? Who was giving you the ability to survive in that confinement? Who? And this is where Allah is reminding us that we depend on Him. And then the time comes for exit. The time comes for transferring from one place to another place. Who is the one that brought you out of the womb of your mother? Who channeled you out? Is it you? Allah says He is the one that made your channel, your process of transferring from that section into this world. He is the one who brought you out into this world. So you see, and even then when you come out into this world, it is the same stage, same period, Allah is saying, you know, you are weak. Think about it. Helpless. And the first thing Allah made mention of, you cry. The infant cried. Why? Because the infant now needs attention. It is drawing the attention of the mother towards it. It needs sustenance of food in the form of liquid. So you see, all of these stages we pass through without even reflecting and thinking of what it was like in the beginning. This is the beginning. And then from this stage, you are out into this world and you are developing and you are growing. So Allah SWT now tells us, after that stage of weaknesses, Allah tells us, ثُمَّ جَعَالَ مِنْ بَعْدِ دُوْفٍ قُوَّةً. And after that stage of weaknesses, Allah now gives you strength. All of us here. Grown up. Big men, big women. Strength in our bodies. We are able to do things. We are able to help ourselves. And this is a very critical stage. Because this stage wouldn't last long, you know. This stage of strength that we have, man boasts about it. See? Forgetting his past. Forgetting the one who sustained him when he was nothing in the sense of, you know, stages of development. And now he comes into this world fully grown, powerful, boasting. As Allah made mention in Surah Yasin, you know, the last ruku in Surah Yasin. This same man who created from a nutfa, from a drop, become an open adversary to Allah. Opposition to Allah. The sense that man is saying, I will not be brought back to life. The time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an enemy of the Prophet came to him and he had the decay of a bone of an animal in his hand, almost to powder. And he brought it before the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his hands and he says, will Allah bring back this bone to life? And he blew the dust in the face of the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah responded by revelation to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, Allah will not only bring back that bone to life, but he will bring back you to life as well. So you see, man forget his past. He forget he was once in need and helpless and was nothing. Now Allah gave him strength, caused him to grow. He is powerful, he is strong, and he become an adversary to Allah. But Allah didn't stop there. As I said, this stage, the second stage in which we are now, growing up, developing ourselves, working, sustaining ourselves. that stage of weakness we pass through. Now the second stage of sort of dependency or not dependency, but you are on your own. And then Allah tells us about this third stage. So as I said, this second stage wouldn't last long, you know. Time is going so fast, life is moving so fast. I mean, just the other day we were infants, isn't that so? Now we are big men and women. So this period is very short. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the third stage, ثُمَّ جَعَالَ مِنْ بَعْدِ قُوَّةٍ دُوفًا وَشَيْبًا. It's frightening, you know. And then Allah tells us, then He created, you see now, we are in this stage of strength. Isn't that so? But then Allah says, and after strength, He will bring you back weak again. You see it? It is there before our very eyes. Many of us, 50, 60, 70, 80, coming back weak again. Not only coming back weak, but we're coming back gray. The hair is changing in our body. So you see, beginning stage of weakness, middle stage of strength, and then coming back at the end, Allah will bring you back to a stage of weakness again. And I mean, look what is happening, family, you know, everybody, so many sick, so many people are weak, so many people are helpless, so many. Many end up in the hospital, in the medical centers, or wherever they may be. This is the third stage. Allah bring you back to a state of weakness that you become dependent on others again. So the lesson here, brothers and sisters, do not, you know, do not boast of who we are and what we are. Do not boast of our achievements. Do not boast about our strength and our physical, you know, ability to do things and feel that it was me and me and I and I. Allah say no. He will bring you back to a stage of weakness again. And this is what we have to prepare for. We have to realize that Allah, our Creator, is in control of everything. We have to realize that we shouldn't take and cannot take, you know, every day we will be the same. We cannot give that guarantee. Today you might be healthy and strong, tomorrow that's gone. So in essence, Allah begins our process in a state of weakness, in a state of helplessness, letting us know that He is the one who brought us through all these stages. You see, and as I said, many of us are heedless of this. Many of us feel that it is my own self. And this is general among mankind. Forgetting the one who created him. Forgetting the one who sustained him. Forgetting the one who bring him out into this world. And not realizing that we have to go back to that same. So my dear brothers and sisters, when we can reflect, and when we can think back, it will help us, you know, to live our lives in humility and humbleness. It will help us to help others, you know, who are in such state that they need help. So in this one ayah of Quran, Allah brings to our attention what we were, who we are now, and what is there for us later on. We do not know. Some of you may pass and leave this world, or some of us may leave this world before the final stage of Shaiva, you know, grief. But when you reach these stages, your mind go back. And give praise and thanks to Allah for bringing you into this world. And to Him we have to go back. So my beloved brothers and sisters, Allah reminds us of our stages of life. And as I said, you know, people go through this day, the entire life, without any reflection of the past. Right? Even without reflection of the future, of the present. Much more for what is to come to them, we do not. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us an understanding. Do not take this life for granted. Do not feel you have full control of yourself. You know? And the amazing thing about this ayat, it is right before our very eyes. We have seen it. We have seen it, right? Think about your parents. Those of you who have parents still alive and what condition they are in. Think about yourself. That is why Rasul Salam used to make dua constantly, Allah, do not afflict me with any difficulties in my old age. I later become old. Protect me from that. You see? That is what it is, and this is how it is, and this is how Allah created us and wants us to know He is the Creator. So may Allah bless us, may Allah grant us goodness in the rest of our lives. You see, when we can reflect and think back, there is no room for boasting. There is no room for feeling that I am the greatest. The beloved Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, what has met you was not going to pass you. And what has passed you was not going to meet you. We ask Allah to protect us from whatever may come our way that will be difficult for us. We ask Allah to continue to bless us with health and strength. We ask him to protect us from any shortcomings that may come our way, and to forgive us and grant us, you know, when we leave this world, understanding that everything it was from Him and is from Him, and everything has to go back to Him. We ask Allah to forgive us and grant us Jannah, inshallah. Aqulu qawli hadha, astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'iril muslimin, wa kullu dhanbin astaghfirullah innahu ghafurur rahim.